out so long it look like up to me. They look up to me. I got fake people showing fake love to me. Straight up to my face. Straight up to my face. I've been down so long it look like up to me.
The luxury of having passion. I want it.
You don't got no sauce, man. You're lost. But you also get lost in the sauce. Bitch gonna get lost in the sauce, man.
Power of the J. It's the power of the J. Weekend after weekend. It's the power of the J. Mama birthed the soldier. Daddy raised a king. Hoes made a monster. Niggas brought out the beast. I ain't even wanna do it. Knew it's time to eat. Spit them out. Bon appetit. That's the power of the G. She can keep her hands off me. In the club. Who she freaky? In the club. Doing it for me. Weekend after weekend. Taking trips. Weekend after weekend.
What you mean. But this girl is like parked right behind my car and she waiting for me to get out. And I'm not trying to get in trouble for hitting nobody freaking car. Like she right there, like, am I wrong? But like, I'm not putting my foot on the gas or nothing. Like, you need to move. Like, go find a different parking spot because I'm not moving until you move. I am not trying to be responsible for hitting nobody's car. I hope they start honking at her so she can move. I need to get out the car and act like I'm, that I wasn't leaving. You need to go because you holding up traffic. Like, I'm not, like, she legit. I was trying to, like, flash my lights on my car so she could see where my car was so she would stop inching up so I could give her the spot. But she legit is too close to my car for me to back out. Like, if I backed out, I would probably hit her car. And I'm not about to be responsible for hitting nobody's freaking car. But she just sitting there waiting for me to move. I'm not going to move. Yeah. Thank you. She finally got the gist of it. Now, I'm not moving my car so your butt can sit down and hit my... So I can hit your car and then you get mad at me. I don't got money like that. I don't got money at all. I just... Y'all, I'm glad that I did not... I'm glad that I did not... spend my own money on them books, because guess how much money I just spent on books, y'all. I spent over like $200 on books, and then it would have been three, but like one of my books is $100 something, and the other, like, if you get it like hard copy, because they don't have like any rented ones or whatever. So if I were to try to get the new copy, because they don't have any old or used ones, it would be $100 something. But if I were to get the digital version, it's only $78. But she was like, that's only if your teacher accepts you guys getting the digital one. So when I go to class on, I think it's Monday when I take that class. Well, I think when I go to class on Monday, I'm going to try to talk to my teacher and see if getting the digital book is an option. Because, y'all, I know it's other places where you can get the books and stuff, but this is legit my first time not having my books, like, the first day of class. And the only reason was, like I told y'all, like, I didn't take out no loans or whatever, like, when school started, because I had misunderstood, like, the semesters they was giving the loans out for. So when they took everything that I have to pay for out, I was only left. Why are you walking in the middle of the thing? Like, why is she right there? That is not no pedestrian crossway. But so when everything was left, like everything that I had to pay for was left, I only had like $45 left on my financial aid thing. So yeah. But that's ridiculous. This like the most that I done paid for books, y'all. And then that was renting them. It came out to $200 something. That's just from renting my books. Like, y'all, this is ridiculous. Like, I really, And I really, 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 really need another source of income. Like, I seriously do. And I don't know where that source of income gonna come from, because I have to go to work at 2 today, and I really want to call out. And I really wish I, well, I kind of sort of right now, kind of sort of do have it like that, where I can call out and I won't really miss those 5 hours on that paycheck. But I'm not the type to call out. Like, I hate calling out. Like, if I know I'm supposed to be somewhere, like, especially if you work making money, I will feel extremely bad for calling out. And especially since it's gonna put my boss and my coworkers in a tight position, I would not, like, legit do that to them unless, like, I'm really sick or something like that. And I'm not sick, I'm just tired, and I really want to just have time to myself. So I've never taken an off day from any job. Like, never. I can't think of a time I took an off day. I'm the type that usually pick up shifts. I don't take off shifts. So I will feel really horrible. Even though you should take time for yourself and treat yourself and allow yourself to, oh yeah, it is dollar sub day. And I done sat here and got this damn Chick-fil-A from school, and I forgot that they was doing $1 subs today at Jimmy John's. But that freaking line, y'all, if y'all could have saw that, that line is out the door. And I gotta be to work by 2. It's like 11 something right now, 12 something. I don't know what time it is, because being in that bookstore took extremely long, like longer than I expected it to. So I really don't even know what time it is currently. But yeah, $200 something, and I got, y'all, I don't understand. And it was one book that caused it to be $200 something, because the one book was like $168. And y'all, that's ridiculous. Like, y'all would think by now, since I'm almost done at this school, that I would already have got like a place where I can get my books for the low. And I need to get that, like, Destiny, and I shouldn't have even got any books. I should just go to the library when I got assignments due and just check out the book or read the book at the library, because that crap is ridiculous. Like, what Destiny does is she'll get the books from the library, and like, she'll use them for whatever time that they allow you to use the books or whatever, and then she just turns them back in. And every time when she needs to use the book for like a homework assignment or something, like, she'll just go and check the book out or go and read the book in the library. And that's very smart, but with me and my work schedule and stuff like that, I need to have my stuff on hand, because I'm not gonna feel like going to a library. Like, when I get off work at nighttime, I'm not gonna feel like going to a library just to do my homework assignments and stuff like that, because sometimes, like, I'm really tired. And so I will go to sleep and then wake up later on in the day to later on in the night to do my homework assignments. Like, I'll get home around like 7 something or 8 something, and I'll take a nap, and I'll wake up, and then I'll do whatever homework assignment. I'm not gonna feel like driving all the way to the library in order to do my homework. So that's why it's kind of an inconvenience. It would save me some money, but it's an inconvenience or whatever. And I'm supposed to, I need to go ahead, I guess tomorrow before I go to work, since I'm not working a 9 to 7 for the first time in a while on a Friday. She got me working 2 to 7. So I guess before, because Crystal's gonna be at my house, so I guess before I go to work on tomorrow, then I'll take her and get the key made, so she can stop having to go to the front office and ask if they can let her in my apartment. Even though she only had to do it twice, like, this will be her second time doing it. Like, she said that the lady was, she should have told me. The lady should have just told me this. She was like, I just might as well go ahead and get a key made. I thought that was, like, against the rules or something. Like, I couldn't do that. I didn't know I could get a key made and let somebody else use my key for my apartment. I didn't know that was allowed. But yeah, so I'm just gonna take her tomorrow before I go to work and get the key made, so she can have a copy with her, so next time she don't have to, like, go to the front office. She could just go straight to my apartment. Yeah, I was just so baffled when she rung up the total, because I rented all of my books, so it's cheaper, but at the same time, I'm thinking that once she take, like, deduct all the stuff from off of it, I'm thinking it's gonna be way cheaper than what it came out to be. And I'm looking at that thing like 200, it's still at 200 something, and I'm like, it would have been 300 something if I would have went ahead and got the other book. But you know what, I was in a lecture hall in that same class. Of course it was a different course, but that man told us that we needed that book in order to pass the class. Y'all, I never opened that, like, I barely opened that book the whole semester. I only opened that book when I was, like, trying to do busy work, like when he was in the classroom talking or whatever and I was getting bored, I would open up my book and, like, write from the book or whatever. But as far as studying from that book and stuff like that, I barely opened that book up, and I spent all that money on getting that book and we barely even used it, and I still passed the class even without using that book like that. So I be feeling like it's a hit and miss, because a lot of the times, honestly, y'all, I done passed all my classes in school. I barely opened up books. Honestly. Like, for real. Like, legit. They are good study tools and stuff like that. But, y'all, I have barely opened up a freaking book during my whole college career. Like, all the ones, at least for all the classes that they claim you need books in, I barely opened up my books, and I still passed my classes. So I'm, like, torn as to if I even should attempt to get this book. And they done had me in that bookstore for that long, my food probably cold as heck. And y'all, I don't know why I've been eating out lately. Like, I guess because I ain't been feeling like really cooking. But this weekend, I'm probably just gonna make some stuff or whatever that'll stretch me. Probably gonna make some pasta because that's, like, something I know that I can eat on for, like, a little bit. But yeah, y'all, I gotta be up to go to work and stuff, and I ain't even gonna back in this park. I'm just gonna pull up in it. I should, but I ain't gonna do it. Yeah, y'all, I'm just like in and eat. Oh, Jesus, I just really cannot wait till I'm done with school. Like, y'all just don't understand, school is annoying. It is so annoying. Like, I could literally be working a job right now and getting paid for my time, and then, like, I feel comfortable taking days off because I could stack my money up and afford to be able to, like, go different places or whatever and stuff. But every time it's like I feel like doing something like that, you got school in the morning. Because it's been times where I'll be home, like, I was talking to my friend Joelle before class, and I was telling her, I was like, it's been days when I get off, or nights I get off from work, and I just be wanting to, like, keep riding and just go out of town. But then I think, and I'm like, dang, I got class in the morning. So I can't do that. But one day, y'all, one day I will have the means to do all that stuff. But, yeah, let's get in this house so I can eat and rest off a little bit. All this stuff in my hand. All right, y'all, I'll talk to y'all in a few. I was so close. Ooh, hate that noise. I was so close, y'all. It's like 1:20 something right now. I was so close to calling out. I had texted my cousin to see if my boss made it, was in today, before I even wasted my time calling. And she said the lady didn't come today. And cause I took a nap after, what are you doing, sweetie? What do y'all not believe in signal lights anymore? Oh my God. dang it. Like, but yeah, I was so close to calling out y'all. Like, I was tired. I had ate before I had went to sleep, and so when I woke up, my stomach was rumbling. So I was like, do I even still want to go to work? Cause it's a 5-hour shift, so I can, I feel like I can. That bird just flew right in front of my car. Y'all, I be so scared when it come to like thinking I'm about to hit an animal. My heart just be dropping. But yeah, I was like, it's 5 hours, it's not a 10-hour shift. Like, I'm not feeling well. Let me just call out, blah, blah, blah. But I was like, let me get my butt up, because I text my cousin. She was like, if I'm gonna do that, then I better hope they don't ask for an excuse. But the thing about it is, this will be my first time ever calling out, like, for a 5-hour shift at least. Because when she was scheduling me to work, those 3-hour shifts or whatever when I was in school, oh my God, why y'all going so freaking slow? You in a row, do you not realize that? I can't wait so I can get the surprise out the way or whatever, so I can just like put this other camera on the freaking thing so y'all can see what I be talking about. Cause that's exactly what I'm gonna use this camera for. Like, that man legit just stopped in the freaking road. And, well, he wasn't even stopped. Like, he was going real, real slow, getting in the turning lane. And it's oncoming cars. Like, why would you do that? And he's sitting up there talking to somebody while he, like, see, if you're going to be distracted, at least pay somewhat attention to the road. But, I'm so stupid. I be so dramatic. Me, I was gonna call out. I was like, let me just get these out of the way, because I don't have to go in early tomorrow, so at least when I get off work today, I have time. And then also, I was like, I don't feel like having Crystal have to go to the front office, so I would prefer for me to be home anyways, to just let her in. She don't have to go through that whole thing of going to the front office and having somebody let her in. I could just let her in. I'm like, oh well, let me just get this money. Let me just go ahead and get this money. Oh, why would you pull in front of me? Yeah, I'm so irritated. Y'all ever wake up and then people just be doing stuff and you just woke up, so you get easily irritated? That's what's going on right now. Cause people doing stuff is pissing me off. Like, why would you get in this lane? Like, why? And if you were gonna get in this lane, you should have waited, cause you just saw me get in this lane. Been dating the other time if it wasn't for the person like finding me or whatever. I didn't find them, they found me, type thing. I'm not about to go out there. I'm not getting on no Tinder. I'm not getting on none of them social media things for dating. I'm not going looking for nobody. I don't care. I'm just going to enjoy my single life, because I realize that I'm not ready for no relationship. That I'd rather be to myself, and it's cheaper being single. I'm so freaking petty. It's cheaper being single, honestly, because when I cook meals, I don't have to cook them to share, so my meals will stretch longer whenever I start back cooking, because I've been eating out lately. Well, not lately. I ate out twice. I ate out three times. I ate out when y'all saw me leave work that night. Then I ate lunch at school yesterday. And then I ate lunch today at school. So just three times I'll be eating out. But that's a lot for me. Because, like y'all know, I cook. So I don't be spending money on the outside getting, like, meals and whatnot. So that was a lot for me. 3 days was a lot. So, yeah. Like, I was thinking about that the other day. I was like, yeah, I want a relationship. And it's like, I know what I want in a relationship. And I know this and the third, blah, blah, blah. But I also know that with my type of lifestyle right now and with my mindset, I would prefer to have everything in order and have everything set and stuff like that before I bring anybody else into my life. And if I bring anybody else into my life, I realize that I want them to be somewhat set and for them to have goals that they're like actively pursuing and stuff like that. And I don't think that's anything like wrong or whatever, but I know that. And I would like, I feel like I would prefer for them to like also have their own and stuff like that. Because, like I told you guys, like this is my first time having my own car. My first time, well, it's not my first time having my own car, but it's my first time having my own car that I bought. It's my first time having my own place and stuff like that. And it's still fresh. I moved out in August. I got my car in February of last year. So this stuff is still like considered mine. Like this is my first time having these things on my own, getting myself these things and stuff like that. And I'm not ready to share. And I'm not ready to like, oh, this is ours, blah, blah, blah. I realize I'm not ready for that. So there's no need to force myself to be ready for it. There's no need at all. I'm very straightforward with people when it comes to, oh, I'm not ready for a relationship and stuff like that. Some people don't listen to that, but I'm very straightforward to it when it comes to me telling people that I'm not ready for a relationship. So it doesn't matter how well you treat me or whatever, or this and the third. If you're not ready for something, you can't force yourself to be ready for it. And I realize that I'm not ready for it, so I can't force myself to be. And that's something that I've come to terms with. And I've been come to terms with it. I just wanted to acknowledge that there will be no dating. I feel, and y'all know what's really strange and what I really dislike? The fact that it seems like I would be more willing to rekindle an old flame than to meet a new person. Because it's like, at least with an old flame, you kind of know their ways and stuff. And it's bad because I really don't like, hashing up old relationships and stuff like that. But it's like, at least you know with that person, the dislikes and stuff like that. You know already what y'all had to or need to work on or whatnot. You kind of know that already. And then with the new person, you have to kind of learn. You have to learn what you don't like. And you have to learn, like, relearn everything with them. And they may be just, like, total opposite of what you want in a person or stuff. Like, it's hard to explain, but y'all get what I mean. Like, who feels that way? Like, it's easier to, even, like, intimately, it's easier to, we're grown here. It's easier to go back to a person that you've had sex with before or that you've been intimate with before. Like, it's easier to, like, go back in a situation with them rather than open up a new can of worms and be intimate with somebody else. Like, I don't know if it's that. What y'all think? Is it just that for me, you being familiar with that person, and so therefore that makes you more comfortable with them and comfortable with opening yourself up to them and stuff like that? Or, like, what do you think it is? But, yeah. Because I find that in myself, like, unless, like, we really, 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 really burn the bridges and stuff, like, we end up on a really bad term or something like that, then, like, it's easy for me to talk to people that I've had encounters with or encountered before. Like, it'll be easier for like, let me use Mariah for example. Even though we didn't work out this time, we were better than what we were last time. And it's just basically the same issues from last time is what caused us to break up. But it was like the tables had turned or whatever. I don't know. Girl, I don't know. But basically, it was easier for us to work through problems and work through issues this time around due to the fact that we already knew each other and we already knew, like, certain things about each other. Otherwise, like, if it was a new person, you would have to learn those things about that person. But in that scenario, that time around, it was kind of easier for us to work things out and easier for us to, like, not go to bed mad at each other and stuff like that, because we kind of already knew what the deal was with each other. As to if it was a new person, you don't know until you get into those situations how to handle them. So, yeah. I'm not really gung-ho for getting back with exes and stuff. I'm just really, I'm making a generalized statement that it is easier to find yourself back with an individual that you once dealt with before, rather than trying something new with somebody else and being like going into uncharted territories and stuff like that. But yeah, I was just thinking about that lately, because I've noticed that I'm so much, and I've said this to people before that have tried to date me. I've told them that I feel like I'm happier when I'm single. I do have those moments where I get tired of being single and I feel sad because I feel like I'm lonely and whatnot, but that don't last always. And when that feeling is over, I'm back to being happy with being single. And it's really odd. It's just, with me, I feel like I would like to have the option of having a person there without the, like, true commitment sometimes. And I'm not talking about, like, sexually. I'm talking about, like, option to talk to the person, option for them to come over for dinner occasionally and stuff. And then, like, when I feel like I'm in my moods where I don't want to be around nobody, then I can be to myself and I'm not obligated to have a person, like, up under me and stuff like that. I feel like that's what I would really need right now. But it's not even a need, that's a want. And it's like, girl, I don't know. It's like I've been having this familiar feeling. Y'all ever had those? Like, for real, y'all, me and my sister, we know exactly, like, anytime me and one, like, either me or her say this, we know exactly what we talking about. But I don't know if other people get it. You know, like, how different seasons or different times of the year come around. Don't it give you, like, a certain familiar feeling? Like, some, or like a smell or something. It smell like a memory or something like that. Like, we have those moments and stuff, and then we'll be like, she'll be like, yeah, girl, it feel like spring of 2012 or something like that. Like, it's stuff like that, and we always be having these feelings. And lately I've been having that familiar feeling, and it's been making me feel good. And I don't know what familiar feeling it is, but it's been making me feel hella good and putting me in a really good mood, and I really love it. And I get that feeling around this time of year now and stuff. So yeah, it's a really good feeling, you guys. And I don't know if it's just us that be having that feeling or us that be saying that and stuff like that, but I just wanted to know, do any of y'all have that same thing going on where it'll be a certain time of the year or you smell something or something like that, and it's like it just smells familiar or it feels familiar to you? Leave me a comment so I can see who else is with us. Like, who else has those moments like me and my sister do? But yeah, they doing work on this bridge again, y'all. I don't think y'all ever knew that, but this bridge always end up getting worked on. I moved to Orlando. Before I moved to Orlando, they was working on this bridge. Then it was like a year after I had moved back, that's when they finally stopped working on this bridge. And now they working on the bridge again. I don't know what they're doing exactly, but they have the cones up and stuff like that. I don't know why they continuously mess with this freaking bridge. It's a freaking bridge. Leave it alone. I'm not trying to fall through it. But yeah. know what time it is. I don't know how late I'm gonna be, but it is what it is. I probably won't be late, honestly. Well, it's 1:45. Yeah, I won't be late. I'm not gonna be late. Unless, like, I get caught by a light, then I might be. But yeah, I'm gonna get off this camera. I done rambled enough. I will talk to you guys in the next vlog. I know the last one, I did not end it properly. So, yeah, I love you, best friends. If you're new to my channel, please click subscribe and become one of my best friends. And I will see you in the next one. Don't forget to leave me a comment because I love hearing from you guys. I love you. Bye-bye.